everyone. Welcome once again to our Smart Mate session. I'm C. Tobejane, and in today's session, we are still looking at an RC integrator. Here, we try to unpack some of the most complex and complicated questions you might find in the examination room. In today's session, we'll be looking at example 1.4, extracted from the TVET First textbook by Macmillan and Troopend Publishers. In today's session, we are expected to calculate a several number of questions. Now let us dive right in. The question on your screen is written as follows. In an RC integrator circuit, a resistor has a value of 8 kilo ohms and is connected in series with a capacitor having a capacitance of 2 microfarads. Calculate the time constant of the RC integrator circuit. The initial voltage across the capacitor at T0 if the capacitor is initially uncharged. The output voltage Vout at T is equal to 3 time constant, assuming the input is a step function with a V minus 0, which is 0 volt, and a V 0 plus, which is 10 volts. The cutoff frequency of the RC integrator circuit in hertz. The voltage across the capacitor 2 seconds after the input step changes, assuming a step input of 12 volts. Now, these are the questions that we have. Let us attempt to them one at a time. Now, the first question, they want us to calculate the time constant of an RC integrator. We know by now that the time constant of an RC integrator will be calculated by R times C. Now, R is given to us in kilo ohms, whilst C is given to us in microfarads. Remember, folks, always keep your calculators handy and ensure that you reset it before you use it. This will enable you to get accurate answers and eliminate some infringed answers that you might have encountered, especially when you have tampered with some settings in your previous paper. Now here, we get that the time constant of this RC integrator is 16 milliseconds. Right, it's 16 milliseconds. The second question says, calculate the initial voltage across the capacitor at T is equal to 0 going positive if the capacitor is initially uncharged. Right, so at exactly T is equal to 0, the value of the capacitor will also be equal to 0. Because at that point, they are saying to us the capacitor is uncharged. Right? If the capacitor is uncharged and the time of charging is at 0, but going to the positive, yet it's still at 0, the voltage across that capacitor will be 0. It's nothing but a trick question. The third question says, calculate the output voltage where your time or your T is equal to 3 time constant, assuming that the input is a step function with a V going to the negative being 0. It means that it does not go to the negative, but it goes to the positive, to 10. Now, what is the equation to use here? We're going to use the equation V out is equal to V0 plus, because V0 minus, we have nothing there, into 1 minus E to the power negative T over time constant, right? Now, they are saying that our positive voltage would be 10, in this case, 1, E to the power, and they are saying the time is 3 times constant, so it's going to be negative 3, multiplied by 16 exponent negative 3, 16 exponent negative 3, we punch that in our calculators. We have 10, 1 minus e to the power negative 3 times 16 to the power negative 3 over 16 to the power negative 3. And the voltage there is given as 9.502 volts. That is the output voltage at 3 time constant. Really, what they are trying to do here is just to introduce something tricky. It's the same as them asking you to calculate the voltage at 3 time constant. Really, there isn't much there. Now, let us move to number 4. Number 4, they want us to calculate the cutoff frequency. The cutoff frequency is given by 2 pi time constant. The cutoff frequency, it's merely given by 2 times pi times time constant. So that is 2 pi multiplied by 16 exponent negative 3. So 1 over 2 16 exponent negative 3. That's just that. That is merely that. That is 9.947 hertz. That is 9. Let us erase this because we've already substituted. That is 9.947 hertz. And then the last question for this one, they want us to calculate the voltage across the capacitor 2 seconds after the input step changes, assuming that a step voltage in this case is 12 volts, right? So they want us to calculate the voltage across the capacitor. So the voltage across the capacitor is the same voltage on the output. Remember, on an RC integrator, the voltage, the output voltage here is collected across the capacitor. Therefore, this means that the output voltage will be equal to the capacitive voltage in that case. V0 plus 1 minus e to the power negative t over time constant. Now, in this case, we are given 12 as our step voltage. And here, we are given 2 as our time. They no longer said 1 time constant, 2 time constant, 3 time constant, but they are just giving us the time. They want the voltage across the capacitor 2 seconds after the step voltage. In this case, we still use the very same time constant. Just like that. Punch that in our calculators. That will be 1 minus e to the power negative 2 divided by 16 exponent negative 3. Now, what is the value of our capacitor 2 seconds after the step voltage? It will be exactly 12 volts. It means that the capacitor will be fully charged. Capacitor will be fully charged. That's it for me today, folks. Let's meet again for another exciting session of Industrial Electronics N5.